Newspapers during the Great Migration were extremely important for the move. However, it depended on which paper you happened to be reading. The difference was whether the newspaper was from the North and black-owned, or from the South and white-owned. The white Southerners realized they were about to lose their Negro workforce. So, to deter them from leaving, they used the newspapers to scare them into staying. The Southern headlines read, "Taking away our labor, the Montgomery Advisor." "Officers look for recruiters who are fooling the Negroes," Jacksonville Times Union. Negroes were badly fooled and deserted. "We want to go home," now the cry of hundreds who left, Atlanta Constitution. "Negroes are dying of cold in the North." However, one of the black-owned northern papers, the Chicago Defender, was one of the leading papers in helping the migrants move from south to north. Many migrants wrote to the Chicago Defender, asking advice and seeking help.
"Your paper was all we had to go by, so we are dependent on you for further advice."
To the Chicago Defender, "I wants to know if there's any way you can oblige me by helping me to get out of here, as I am anxious to leave here. And everything's so hard here, I hope you will oblige me in helping me to leave here at once to 309 Middle Street. Sincerely, Mrs. J. H. Adam."
The Chicago Defender was a source of valuable information. Its articles declared the North the land of plenty. Factory jobs were abundant, housing was plentiful, and there were new churches. This was a land where Negro men could be police officers, and where one could become successful in business.
African-American artist Jacob Lawrence created one of the best-known artistic depictions of the Great Migration. Although Lawrence created these paintings in the early 1940s, they are a good representation of the movement.
"Yes, I'm built out and bound to go. I'm gonna leave here running, because walking is most too slow. I'm going down.
The Migration series of paintings depicts the difficulties of poor rural African Americans making the journey to the urban North. Like other artists that depicted the Great Migration, he uses color to evoke emotions. Bright reds and sad blues fill the canvases in the series. In the first painting of the series, Lawrence depicts three northern destination hotspots for the Great Migration: Chicago, New York, and St. Louis grew rapidly after the war and promised better employment and housing opportunities to rural black workers from the South. In the 14th and 15th paintings, Lawrence depicts the desperation that many Southern black men and women faced at the time. Southern courts were harsh in their judgments and lynchings were common.
"Now give me one more kiss, baby. Yes, just before I go. 'Cause when I leave you this time now, baby, I declare I won't be back no more."
In painting number 60, Lawrence portrays the multitude of newcomers to the North. It is crowded and overwhelming. Although people migrating to the North had been promised a better way of life, it often was just as cruel and desperate. Many artists who depict the Great Migration attempt to evoke hope, but that is not the case for Jacob Lawrence. His paintings show the hardships of leaving one's home, family, and friends for the unknown.
"Yeah, yes, I had to say goodbye. 'Cause I'm gonna walk the soul highway, babe, until the day I die. You know I'll be on my way. I'm gonna walk the soul highway, babe, until the break of day.
As with other blacks, Southern musicians flooded northward in an attempt to escape the harsh reality of life in the South. Going north for these musicians helped hopes of making a living off their music, a dream that would not be realized in their Southern homes. Artists like Lead Belly, Muddy Waters, and Howlin' Wolf found success in their journey north, while others faded into the crowds of factory workers. Many artists use their music as an expression of hard times in the South, hope in the North, or just a longing for a better life.
Limbo Weevil, I'll tell you a little story about it, which is a little bug long years ago robbed people of their homes. And ever since the boy Weevil been gone, the people have been singing this song. You can talk about the latest of your own. These bold Weevil, they will rob you of a home. They're looking for a home. They're looking for a home. First time I seen the boy Weevil, he was sitting on a square. Next time I seen the boy Weevil, he had his whole family there. He's looking for a home. He's looking for a home.
Lead Belly, who lived a life filled with violence, sang about the injustices and hardships in the South.
This old Jim Crowisms did bad luck to me and you. I've been traveling from toe to toe. Everywhere I have been, I find some old
Tired of getting hard, boys are getting scared. Soon as I gather my cotton and corn, I'm bound to leave this place. White folks sitting in a parlor, eating their cake and cream. Pickles way down the kitchen, squabbling over turnip greens.
Other artists like Ida Cox sing about the foreseen prosperity in the North.
Got the blues so bad I'm gonna leave old Binghamtown. Got the blues so bad I'm gonna leave old Binghamtown. My man caught a train, it was Chicago bound.
The Great Migration brought a wave of musicians to the North, transforming the music scene in Chicago and New York. Music was a vital art form in the Great Migration, a unique expression which was viewed with reverence by black and white alike.